Hi everyone, happy Thursday lunchtime. I hope you're doing well. So today we're just going to jump straight in with another Thursday Truths from me. Today's is all about statistics, and one statistic in particular that states that you are more likely to have endometriosis in your 30s and 40s. I was speaking to a mum earlier in the week who had been told that their daughter was unlikely to have endometriosis because she was too young. Now this made my blood boil because it's not true. As I know a lot of you know, a lot of you were diagnosed or potentially diagnosed a lot earlier than your 30s and 40s. I myself was diagnosed in my sort of early mid 20s. And a lot of people now are diagnosed before 30s and 40s. However, statistics, older statistics that some doctors still listen to, suggest that most people get diagnosed with endometriosis in their 30s and 40s. This isn't because people don't get endometriosis earlier than in their 30s or 40s. This is simply because of the diagnostic techniques that they used to use in order to diagnose endometriosis. So these days, obviously, we have the laparoscopy. That's the only clear way, 100% way at the moment, to that's widely used to diagnose endometriosis. Before the laparoscopy, we had a laparotomy that I can never say, and the laparotomy was used to diagnose endometriosis. Now, laparotomy is a way more invasive procedure than the laparoscopy. If you think the laparoscopy is bad enough, which it is, the laparotomy was way more invasive, and the risks of that were a lot worse than the laparoscopy, predominantly around infertility, causing complete infertility. So the chances of you being able to have children after you've had one were significantly reduced. So doctors, when this was the only way of diagnosing endometriosis, doctors were really, really reluctant to carry out this procedure on younger women because, as I say, they didn't want to put that woman, put that person, that woman through a procedure which may dramatically reduce or even completely reduce their chances of having children in the future. So they would put off this operation or this procedure until the later in life when the woman didn't necessarily want to have children, which is why statistics from years ago state that people were diagnosed in their 30s and 40s, because that's when they used to put off the diagnosis too. Now you have, I don't know if you saw my thing the other day about endometriosis being called the career woman's disease. Because again, a lot of people used to assume that it was caused by having children later in life. That's another myth, and it's a similar myth to this. The myth being that actually the women who were diagnosed with endometriosis in their 30s and in their 40s back in the day still had endometriosis in potentially their teens, 20s, but their diagnosis was put off until later life because of the risk to their fertility of having the diagnostic procedure. So that is why statistics are fabulous. I use statistics in my business. I used to use statistics in my 9-to-5 career. They're brilliant for certain things. However, when you forget the context of the statistics you're looking at, and when you just see statistics as a hard and fast rule, forgetting some of the constraints of the data that you're looking at, then they give a false picture. So no. Women, people aren't more likely to have endometriosis in their 30s and 40s. You are never too young to have endometriosis. So if you or one of your loved ones is struggling at a much younger age and you're told that similar rhetoric that unfortunately is still out there, that younger women can't have an endometriosis, that somebody aged 13, 14, 21, 23, whatever age they are, if they're told they're too young to have endometriosis, and the conversation begins to get shut down, then fight back, because the statistics are, they're not out of date because they are true in that people used to be diagnosed at that age, but the reasons behind that is not because they didn't have endometriosis, it's because the diagnostic procedure wasn't suitable to be carried out on younger women. So don't let anybody tell you you're too young to have endometriosis. If you want to chat through your symptoms or anything, please do give me a shout, because sometimes all you need is a bit of reassurance and some positive reinforcement that actually, yes, there is something wrong and these are the things you can do about it. So even if that is just a quick chat with me about the symptoms and whether it is likely that you have endometriosis and some support that you need to go back to your doctors or your specialists to begin to sort that out. Okay, have a lovely Thursday afternoons, have a fabulous weekend, whatever you're doing, and I shall speak to you next Thursday, if not before. Take care, guys.